very small site. It's the site Čáslavice in Central Moravia in the Czech Republic. It is the site where is the plain settlement, really small village, which is from the Middle Bronze Age and Late Bronze Age. It is by us as Tumulus culture and Arfield culture, the Elray Arnfield culture, in the so-called Lusatian Arnfield circle. And to this Arfield culture settlement is here the Arfield cemetery with 106 graves. It is very small site, but I have assessed it, and the most important for me was the possibility to compare the settlement with the burial ground. But today I will speak at most about the burial ground, but we can discuss already all the characteristics. Here is the cemetery. It is to see that it's a three small parts of the cemetery of the rescue excavation digged. Yeah? So the Arfield cemetery in Čáslavice, it is, for me, it is something what I have done already. It was done very for many years, yeah. And at that time I have assessed it and make it with the factor analysis, and I have showed that the most important characteristics of this site are the variable grave goods, that there are, we have the important depth of the graves, which is which causes the fundamental difference in survival and correlates with the number of documented vessels, that the sex of individual was has not affected with the depth of the deposition, and the only anthropological feature was associated with the, or the characteristic was associated with the shallow graves of children. That means that the children graves was very poor. Yeah. So the presence of the bronze is, and the highest numbers of vessels correlate with the buried man that is on this grave, on this factor analysis. After years, when I have seen the book of Gramash, a very important book, and when I have discussed with Katharina Ribej the situation about the double graves and children graves in Moravia, I have looked on it once more, and I have seen that something is wrong. Yeah, when I have taken the anthropological analysis from the last years, I have seen that my analysis, it was not my, it was analysis from Sensnová do Čekalova, my colleagues from the Moravian Museum, made it so that I have no one double grave, and no one double grave with children, but it's, after the new dates, really untypical for the situation in the Arnfields. Yeah? So I have looked on it, and I've asked to my colleague Ivana Jarošová, which assessed for me in the time another sites, Bojkovice. It is the Danube region already, but it is already 80 kilometers south from the Čáslavice, and Zvolen Balkan, which is on the Slovakia, it is for one of our students. And I have compared with the Chodony, what's a work, later work from the Professor Chocho. And I have asked her to reassess the Čáslavice site of cremations with the really important aim to see double graves and the children, new children. So when I look on the map of the Čáslavice site, it is necessary to say that it is really rescue excavation. We have not all the informations about the graves, the documentation is not well, but we can say that we have here as the ungraves, so the graves which have as urn as the some remains in the under the urn, for example, or in the surrounding, and we have dirt unearned graves. Yeah, so they are in the such a small groups, which is typical for our situation. It could be around the tumulus, but it is for the discussion. After the assessment, or the first points of the assessment, we have seen that only part of the cremations is too accessible. We have only not half the cremains with the whole body. In some cremains, we have only long bones and parts of spongioses, and at most the skull is missing. and the other categories are smith small parts of the remains at all. And what we can say about it is that we have about 25% of the Bari population, or from the graves, from the 106 graves, they are only a part of the cemetery. So, and when we speak about the graves, we have these cool zero remains. Here is the 100% correlation with the shallow graves. So we can say that the part of the skull was probably on the top of the cremation. After assessment, we see that we have 43 single burials, three single burials with a few recognizable elements of another individual, one double burial with two mixed individuals, one double burial with two separate individuals, and one double burial with possible mix of two individuals, which is supportive of the weight of the cremation. In total, 52 human individuals. After the bone fragmentation, I want to show here that how it was analyzed, the first thing, but I will want to speak about the correlation of the weight of the pieces under these two sites. It's important to say that the weight of the pieces and as the dimensions of the pieces are really low on whole our region. In the Vojkovice and Praslavice are typical all the pieces from the 10 to the 50 millimeters. It is not only a question of the archaeological excavation. And we have, for example, new excavations where all the bones were flattened. Yeah, and we know that we have a really very low number of pieces which are longer than 50 millimeters. When we have seen here Matthias' paper, we can say to it that we have looped after the fragmentations of the bones, and they are very rare, and it is not count in this table, or it is taken as one piece. Yeah. So I want to say here that it is very probable, and it was already expected that it is some part of the processing of the remains after the cremation here. Yeah, only 60% of all pieces is bigger than 1 centimeter, and only 2% of the pieces are measured more than 5 centimeters, and it is typical. Yeah. And this point, I want to say that there are other regions where are longer these bones, so it is very probable that it is a regional a strategy of the processing of the pieces. Here is only to see that there is a typical correlation under the small pieces of the bones and unknown characteristic of the grave, and that we cannot assess the of this infants or the adult in this type of graves, which have no these small pieces, is logical. So in the what we are speak about the correlation of the color of the bones, it is very typical that is not the same on all sides. It is differentiate very. Here we have two this Vojkovice and Praslavice site. We can see here that it is most differentiable variable in this in my case, and it's not only from this site. We can look in around in the other studies. It could be visit that it is really individual to see a color of bones, so it could be with the individual assess of the person which look on it, or it could be and it is probable that it could be with the local tradition of the site. Yeah. We have looked for other possibilities to something say about this cemetery. We have asked Katarina Basesbury and her team for the two cemetery annulation for to indicates age of some individuals, but it was not successful. Where the was impossible it for the high stay of high degree of cremation. But we have make some experimental part of the assessment with the cremation weight, and we can say that in the table of the possible cremations was only a very small part of the discrete individuals we can assess about it was after all the categories what was necessary to take in 20 individuals which was fulfilling all these conditions for the reassessing this age after the weight of the remains. What are the results from it? It was possible indicate the five of the known infancies after the weight of the long bones or the long pieces of bones as the infants free. It was a question of it is humanist or infants. So when I won't speak about this assemblage, I must say that in the first assessment of this assemblage, we have 30 people which were detected after the sex, men or female. And now we have five only. We were really hyper-realistic in the conclusions, while on the first look, it was to see that we have really differences in the graves, that some graves which were assessed as the men graves, it was probably women graves. And on the end, we have taken the simulation of four categories which were necessary to ask, and only when all the categories was yes or nothing was wrong, I would say we have taken this as a sex determination. So it is really a small number. So when we see this situation, we have 13 non-adults, 17 adults, 2 males, 3 females, 3 double cremations with infants and adult, as I have already said. When we see it in the table, we have the groups, it's 4. And I want to speak about what it means in the social significance of these individuals. It's very interesting, while we have here really another community, as on the beginning, we can see that the graves which are the social significance, where we have counted the number of vessels, the number of bronzes, the situation of the urn and the upper part of the grave. And I want to say here that we have here children. These are the red dots. They are in the through the whole grave. So, and the most social significance graves are to assess women graves. So no one men grave was taken as the with the high index, social index. So here is the situation with the social index in the cemetery. We will that when we can say that it is a concentration of the social significant graves in the center, but we have so rare raster that it is not probable to interpret it so, but we can look about other analogies. So here we have the graves with the methyls. So these are female graves. The one is infants, as I have said, is female infants free, and the second is juvenile adult women. So when I go to the conclusions, the new anthropological processing changed the view on the whole community in the doubling of the children in the graves. We have the multiplied funerals, which correspond to the other current population studies. Now we can see the numbers are really in percentage really near to the other sites. And when we are looking, for example, to the biological profile of the population, it is near to other sites from the Lusatian culture. These are from the Lusatian culture and this is the work of its side here. What is about the other conclusions? It is very important to look on the wider regional joint treatment of the remains. I mean that we can discuss it, for example. We have probably the different bone lengths on major regions. And I want to say that the temperature is very probable, very local tradition. Yeah, so it's my conclusions. Thank you for attention.